I do every day, Mum? What do I do? Get up, catch the bus, go to work, come back home, eat chips and go to bed. Is that it?
It's what the rest of us do.
But I can't.
Why? Because you're better than us.
No, I didn't mean that. It was. It was a better life. And I don't mean all the travelling. The doctor showed me a better way of living your life. You know he showed you too. That you don't just give up. You don't just let things happen. You make a stand. You say no. You have the guts to do what's right when everyone else just runs away.
Humanity is, for the first time in history, becoming consciously awake. Education, information, and dispelling myths allows people to logically look at their world, to shake off the chains that hold them back from finding true happiness. Humanity is tackling issues that have plagued their families for generation after generation. Humanity is learning that they no longer need to be cursed with toxic thoughts that destroy self-esteem and relationships. There is a massive movement toward self-realization, whether it is through spirituality, meditation, nutrition, exercise, self-help, life balance, or psychotherapy. Humanity finally has the tools and information to finally conquer these inner demons that hold us individually down. With this access to information, help, and healing, this generation is tackling their issues and saying, "It stops with me." They will not pass this toxic thoughts onto their children so that they can be their highest and best selves. This, to me, is true generational wealth. Once humanity starts becoming more free in their consciousness, the chain reaction starts ripping through every other aspect of their life. No longer will they put up with abusive, manipulative, and toxic personal relationships. Toxic wives, abusive boyfriends, manipulative bosses, and even rude strangers will no longer be tolerated. Humanity will learn that we do not need to fight these people. They merely need to be identified and exposed so that we may shun them in our lives forever. Once the social parasite is exposed, they will no longer have the control over that newly awakened person, and they will wither away in their current power. The newly freed person will feel an incredible weight lifted off their chest and truly be able to breathe for the very first time. Once they tackle those toxic relationships, it is now time to rid themselves of careers and efforts that do not resonate with their now stirring soul. We all resonate energy, and when we find people or music that vibrates with our energy, we literally get a shiver down our spine. That is our soul or our consciousness telling us that this is real and right, and that we need to be fully present in this moment. We should be searching for these moments in everything we do, but we are held back from it by people who seek to manipulate your energy into their collective efforts for their personal power. When we are surrounded by people or things that do not resonate with us, we feel a dissonance, a sickness in the stomach. We cannot give our best energy to things we do not believe or feel passionate about. Most careers in this debt and death paradigm do not resonate with us because we are feeding a collective beast that does not care about us or our happiness. We currently have millions of Americans on antidepressants or other forms of active denial as a way to cover up the sick feeling that they are not getting anywhere in their life. The secret to happiness is making real progress. Think about when you were most happy. It was probably when you were a child. Every day there was progress and opportunities seemed everywhere. You were told that you can be anything, and you probably had a healthy family structure to provide the encouragement to do more. Your potential was encouraged to take action, which led to results, which leads to certainty, which leads to the confidence to take on any challenge. It is important to note that happiness is not an exponential scale. Take a man who is cold and hungry, and maybe minus 100 happy, and if you give him a warm bed and hot soup, he may become plus 100 happy. But if you give that same man $1 billion, he does not become plus 1 billion happy. We have been fooled into thinking that the collection of dollars or status in some system is the measure for happiness. After we progress ourselves to a point where we can sustain ourselves without fear, the only other happiness you will find in life is being a blessing onto others to reach that same level. Humanity will realize that when this dollar paradigm collapses, that most of their time and energy has been wasted on things that have absolutely no importance to our lives. We have sold our soul every day to do things that did not materially make the world better or bring happiness into other lives. The majority of humanity will be asking what was their life all about when the prosperity built on debt is collapsed. To those that cannot live with toxic thoughts, toxic people, and toxic careers, they will no longer be able to waste another day digging at that empty hole in their soul. They will make the decision to leave that high-paying job and to follow that small voice inside of them. They will realize that the things that they thought they needed are no longer important. And because they no longer desire the latest and greatest, life immediately becomes less intensive and demanding. They are able to support themselves and others with less effort. A greater calm will come over them as they wonder why they did not do this sooner. This change in priority and needs leads to a physical change in where you live. They will move away from urban areas that seem to attract the most narcissistic and aggressive people to places of a slower way of life. In more than a few videos, I have warned people that areas that thrive the most off the debt and death paradigm will be the worst places to be when the dollar collapses. Large urban areas require a constant influx of food, energy, and debt to function. When the dollar collapses, not only will it be the most exposed and least prepared, it will be a hotbed for violence as the aggressive narcissists do whatever it takes to get theirs. If you cannot move from these areas, you need to focus on food, water, and weapons as you try to ride out the storm. The further you are from the impact zone, the fear of starvation will lessen, and more local markets and trust will spring up. The buffer of supplies you need can be smaller as the economy will provide more day-to-day needs. Once you have secured your buffer, it's time to take that last step. The final step is walking away from toxic investments. Your current wealth and ability to support this happiness is the fruit of your past labor. It is vital that you protect it from toxic paper investments and assets. The silver bullet and silver shield calls for you to sell every single paper asset you have and buy real tangible assets to preserve your wealth from the greatest transfer of wealth in human history. Your happiness, and quite frankly, your ability to survive the single largest event in human history, depends on you walking away from the paper paradigm before the dollar mathematically collapses. There is a limit to the amount of food and guns one can reasonably store or need. This leads people to search for items that will retain real value and store a lot of alloidial wealth in a small, portable area. And if you've been watching the hours of the silver bullet and the silver shield, you will know that nothing shines brighter than silver. Not only will you be providing a silver bullet to the debt and death paradigm and things that do not resonate with you, you will also be providing a silver shield to the ones you love so that we can be a blessing onto others.